So we're going to be hearing a little different type of music with Two Rocks Rye in just a moment. And I am going to play a song of theirs, and then they are going to be live in the studio. So listen for more. Let's talk.
No.
we're back with Let's Talk, and we got Two Rocks Rye. We got Matt and Ben here in the studio. Let me put all your, and we have Andy Kinn joining us as well. So welcome, Ben.
That's me. Thank you.
Okay, get close to that microphone. Right. We know you can rock it.
There
you go. And Matt, can
yes.
hear you. All right. Andy Kinn, co-host.
Good afternoon.
All righty.
Made it through the monsoon.
Oh, it was a monsoon.
It wasn't that
there.
Bad.
Like,
no,
me, it was. I was coming down 31 from like High Bridge. It was like 30 miles an hour.
It was
like
over
pouring,
there.
Pouring. All of a sudden, just kind of like this huge deluge. But anyway.
Hey, but we're so glad to have Two Rocks Rye here. Now, we want somebody, Matt or Ben, to tell us who is Two Rocks Rye.
So
I'm going to let the Kiwi take it.
Two Rocks Rye is, we started out as a duo in 2015. And we just started playing
acoustic
together.
Acoustic duo.
Acoustic duo, yep. And in the last year or so, we've added two other guys. So we're now a full band. We've got a drummer and a bassist and vocals and guitars.
It's
and
beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank
really
you.
Great.
Yeah.
Now, where are you out of?
Basically out of Doylestown.
Yeah.
Roughly.
Doylestown, Pennsylvania?
Yeah, yeah, that's where you live, right?
That's right. That's where I live.
That's how I discovered you.
That's
it.
Yeah,
that's Uncle Bobby.
From your Uncle Bobby. From your Uncle Bobby, Mr. Pittsburgh.
That's right.
And that's where I'm from, too. So there you go.
Well, so, I'm glad you landed here in Doylestown.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
The stars aligned.
Yes, that's right. Now, tell us about this album, and what is the name of the album, and what was that first song?
That first song was called Figure It Out. The name of the album is, we've actually just recently decided on it. It's going to be called Saving Claire, based off the ninth track, which is the last song in the album. And our drummer, actually, he's a graphic designer, which is unbelievable to have in a band. And he actually was looking for inspiration through the album, trying to find something to write, something to draw, some sort of emotion to capture. And he said Saving Claire was the one that did it for him. He sent us all the proofs, and we just fell in love with it. So that's soon to come.
Yeah, so we're going to put that out on Spotify and all the rest of it.
Oh, okay.
Pretty
so
soon,
that's
yeah.
where you'll be able to catch it.
Yep, yeah. all of those streaming platforms, and hopefully we'll also burn...
Like Bandcamp or something? Or
Well, the bigger ones.
We're going for the bigger ones.
Yeah, we're going for the sky.
Oh,
like
oh,
Google
right.
Play, YouTube,
Pandora.
Spotify, Pandora,
yeah.
uh-huh. okay.
Apple Music.
Oh, awesome. Okay, so I want to make sure we get through some of your other songs, too. So let me play the second cut. Is that all right?
Sure.
Yeah.
All right.
You're going to play the second track?
Yeah, is that all right?
That's
or
fine
what do you want me to play?
No, second track.
Do number four.
Do number four, okay.
Yeah, number four.
And here I am, Laurie Kay, Let's Talk, trying to figure out the CD player. So hang in with me. Okay. Okay. Hang on just a second.
Good. Highway, highway. Good times will soon be gone.
sorry I kind of cut that off a little short there, but
you ruined it.
I'm so sorry, Matt.
I think you got the gist of it.
Definitely got the gist of it. So what was the name of that song?
That song was called Groove.
Okay. Tell us a little bit about Groove. That was the fourth on your CD, fourth track.
Yeah. So actually, the way we actually started, Ben and I, a friend of ours has a mountain place up in the Poconos. And it was just got to be like 3-4 years ago. He invited us up to just have like a musical jam weekend. There's a bunch of musicians. We all went up to this cabin, hung out, drank, ate, did what we did. And Ben and I hadn't really known each other. We kind of knew each other through him a little bit. And we just started playing a lot of this music and a lot of music from our youth, a lot of the 90s rock. And that stuff just resonates with me and him. And it was funny. We were like standing outside in cold weather. It was like January. And it was almost like we were two teenage kids saying, do you want to start a band with me? Kicking rocks. And I don't know. I don't have anything going on. Okay, we can do that. Let's do that. And so that's kind of how it started. And how it developed was just, I think, our work ethic together. I've never worked with somebody to this extent and actually gotten along with them that well. But for him, I mean, I don't think we ever argue.
So how many members are in the band?
So there's four now. But we started for the first 2 years together, it was just us two.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, now there's four of us.
And now there's four of you. Yep. And where do you record?
Mostly in my basement, actually.
In Doylestown?
It's actually, well, I live just in Chalfont, Warrington kind of area. But yeah, too close to Doylestown.
Yeah, Oh, Bucks County action there.
That's it, yep. So we set up when the kids go to bed, we all go downstairs and our drummer plays an electric kit, so that keeps it quiet, keeps the family asleep, you know.
It's a really good sound to your CD.
Yep. No, it's taking quite a lot of effort.
Yeah.
Many hours of mixing and recording.
It's really
He's a workhorse. So we would get finished to practice at 11:30, 12 o'clock, and we'd all say goodbye, and we'd leave. This is on Tuesday nights. Tuesday nights we practice. And he would, 1:30 in the morning, we'd all get an email. He's already cut up the entire practice, every track that we played. If we played anything new, if we covered anything, and he would just send it out. So the next morning, we all just download it, listen to it on our way to work or at work or whatever. And so everybody's constantly listening.
Yeah. That is awesome.
Yes.
Well, I got to do a little station identification, and then we're right back with Two Rocks Rye.
You are listening to 89.7 WDVR, Delaware Township, and 90.5 WPNJ, Easton.
WDVR invites you to receive our monthly electronic newsletter and learn more about our programming. Just send your email address to wdvrhost@comcast.net. Thanks.
All right, we're back with Matt and Ben and co-host Andy Kinn, and they are Two Rocks Rye. Where can we see Two Rocks Rye perform?
So I think our next full band gig is at Frolic's Farm in, where is it?
Furlong. Yeah, it's not right on 263. It's just outside of Doylestown. They have like
Pennsylvania.
In Pennsylvania. We need to
say that because we're in New Jersey
now. Okay. I was just telling him on the way here. I was like, we went over the river. I know we're in Jersey, but I don't feel, and it doesn't feel any different.
No. It's all the USA. Hey, we're here just over the river. So when is it?
It's on October the 5th. And we're playing between 6 and 9 p.m.
Okay. Yeah. It's outside. They have brewers there. They have family fun things. And we're playing on an outside kind of lawn area. But it's all out in the field. It was a huge success last year. So
wonderful. So is there a website where people can check you out?
Generally, we do everything through Facebook.
Okay.
So if you search for Two Rocks Rye on Facebook, or even we have a YouTube channel that has quite a few videos and stuff on it. We don't really specifically have a website dedicated to us. We just use those kind of platforms at the moment.
Okay. TWOROCKSRYE.
That's right.
All right.
Like the drink.
like the drink. Okay. We're going to play some more music the rest of this half hour because we want everyone to hear your music. So which one do you want me to play here? Which track?
Should we go with The Last Cowboy next?
I
think we should go for The Last Cowboy. And we need, oh, you know what? Before she does, I think we need to say hi to our other band members.
We should probably mention them by name.
Yes, we should. So our drummer, an amazing artist, Mr. Brian Shaw. Hello, Brian. We're listening.
All right.
You're listening.
And then there's Brendan Cassidy. He's our bassist.
Okay.
So I just want to say hi to those two fellas.
Hey, and we'll get to hear them play.
So is number seven, if that's...
Number seven.
Track number seven.
Okay. Here you go.
Call me in my days. fancy clothes on a Friday night. Shaking off the day today. Get loose now, it's time to fade away. What you feel now won't last. What you feel now won't last. We don't have the answers, you gotta give it to mine. We don't have the answers.
Think this is it for me. Memories of your identity.
And they're right here.
No, I don't know about that.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Love your music. And I'm going to ask you a little bit, Matt and Ben, about some of your influences when you're, because you're both songwriters, so we're going to talk about that too. So who are some of your influences, Matt?
Oh, I thought you were going to let us decide. I tend to gravitate towards I guess male vocalists, dominant male vocalists. So Eddie Vedder's a big one for me. Pearl Jam, they were a huge influence growing up. I really like Ray LaMontagne, Dave Grohl, the Foo Fighters, just kind of that whole genre of 90s rock really kind of resonated with me. And you just, when you do it yourself, you just kind of find your own path, though. You take little bits and pieces from people, you know, I call them your Easter basket, and you know, I'll take that and some of that and some of that. And you go on YouTube and you watch documentaries and you watch interviews and you're trying to, well, what are they doing that I'm not doing? And then you just kind of figure out your craft from there. I'm still learning as we go. It's a long, tedious process. And we're still learning each other. I think we've gotten it down, though. We're pretty,
I mean, every song's different, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes Matt will come up with a riff, and even sometimes a riff and vocals and everything. And sometimes I'll come up with a riff, and I generally don't do the vocals. Matt does those, but you know, he'll come up with a riff. I'll come up with a chorus or something.
Okay.
And we kind of share a lot of influences.
Okay.
I have a bit of a jazz background as well. I study jazz back in New Zealand, so that kind of comes into some of the songs. But yeah, it's pretty.
When you say you study jazz, what kind of jazz? It's such a broad area.
So I study specifically jazz performance on the guitar. That was my kind of, you know, my major. But, you know, and we studied a wide variety of styles of jazz at school.
I heard about what goes on at jazz school. You don't really.
I'm not allowed to talk about it.
Well, I'll tell you, there's so many different kinds of jazz. And how would you define your music?
You mean the music we?
Yes, you play.
I mean, I think it's rock. I would say it's rock music.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
But you have a little bit of that beat too with the, when you talk about jazz, you could actually kind of incorporate that somehow, can't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Like, you know, just the knowledge of harmony and stuff kind of comes into it sometimes. Yeah.
So Ben, when did you become a songwriter?
I don't know if I'm more of a riff writer than a songwriter, you know.
I'll give yourself more credit.
What do you mean a riff versus a song?
Like a guitar, you know, idea basically. I'll come up with a few guitar ideas that may kind of go together, and they end up becoming a song. But I guess that's writing songs.
Writing songs.
And I've done that all through. Like,
so how about you, Matt? Whenever it comes to the words, comes to the poetry.
Yeah. So I could not write worth. I can't say that, can I? No.
Worth a damn.
Darn. I couldn't write a song to save my life about 10, 15 years ago. I tried. I was doing open mics, and I was like, I'm not ready to explore this area yet. I'm not that interested in it. And then, you know, when we started linking up, there was some certain pieces of music that we just started gravitating towards, and I was like, well, I'll give it a shot. Well, I think the first song that we actually wrote was terrible. I wrote it.
And it's not on this album.
And it was kind of before Ben and I got together. And I came over to his house, and I think you were, Elise was about to be born at that
point.
Yeah,
she was, yep.
Yeah, and I came over to your house. I was like, I got this great idea for this song. It's amazing. We should really do something with this. And you're like, all right. And so he mixed it and everything. We recorded it in the basement, and he sent it to me. And it's forever labeled Matt's song. Ben doesn't want to have anything to do with it. It doesn't really have a title. But that was kind of like step one into that. And I think probably the next one was that number 16 one.
Yep, and Saving Claire was.
And Saving Claire was early too. Yep. So.
So number 16 is.
That is a
which one, on your which track?
That
number 5.
Number 5, and that song was actually written. It was actually written as an apology letter to a friend.
Oh.
And it worked.
Wow! So we should hear that.
I think it worked. I mean, we talk.
Should we jump into that?
Yeah, let's play number 16.
That sounds so interesting.
Hmm. Yeah.
Okay, here I go. All right. I'm gonna. Oops. I got it by George. Okay.
George isn't here.
Okay.
Since I saw your face, the memories we shared, oh, we shared a place. Gone is the time, that time amongst men, the time when we laughed, we spoke, we joked, oh, as friends. Now in feeling down, how this came to be, the story of friendship, of you and me. I once called you brother, to me the same. All that I needed, wanted, loved, I'm to blame. Now we're getting on,
this can go on. We could repair, regenerate, rejoin these neurons roar. Let's make a highway to the sunset we'll drive. We'll find the cold, a drink, a smoke, and settle down inside. That's known from the silence, yeah, throughout the years. I've grown inside, embracing a change to my soul, my heart, my eyes, all but my name. I'll say I'm sorry, yeah, that's what you need. Hell, I drop the story of who is to blame. This letter is different than ones before. If you accept, say yes, just call me at your door. Yeah, we're getting old,
yeah, we're getting old.
And this can't go on. Join these new roads are on. Let's make a highway to the sunset we'll drive. We'll find a cold, a drink, a smoke, and sit down inside. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah,
going to go on to the title track, and there's going to be a little bleep in there, so hopefully we bleep at the right time. But it's Saving Claire, and that is the title of Two Rocks Rye new CD, their first CD, and it's such a joy to have them here on Let's Talk today. So let's listen to Saving Claire. Well, that wasn't Saving Claire. I went back too far. Okay. Now it's Saving Claire, Two Rocks Rye. Thank you.
her bed. No, she's sleeping. What's her life for? She's not breathing. She's drowning. Over and on, she comes round, round.
Rocks Rye. Thank you so much for being here, Matt and Ben.
Thank you.
You're
Laurie.
Welcome. Thanks
Thank
for having
you,
us. Mm-hmm.
Would you mind if we just gave a shout out to our loved
yes.
ones at home?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you to anyone who's listening, including my wife, Amy, and anyone else out there.
Yeah. I know that my wife, Tracy, Emma, and Charlotte are all in the kitchen listening. So I just want to say hi to them. Well, love you guys.
Thank you Very for good. Being yeah. on Let's Talk, and we love it. Two Rocks Rye, Saving Claire. Look for it. You can find it on Spotify, and you can find
coming
it.
Soon, yeah.
Coming soon,
yeah.
Coming
and,
soon.
And look for them over at the Frolic...
Frolic's Friday Night Farms.
Friday Night Farm, October the 5th. Okay, thanks for listening to Let's Talk today, and we'll be back next week.